Hello and welcome back to Car Mechanic Simulator 2015. Yes, it's a 8:15 and at least 10 minutes since I used that joke. Alright, so last time we were doing up the last piece of junking auction bought nonsense we'd had, the Bianca I think it was. As you can see, they're all purplish now, pinky purple, so what we want to do next is pop into the auction and buy some more junkers to do up. Carcomplaints.com, eh? Good. Let's do this. Alrighty, so here we are. Just have to... 12 items on the list today. So let's see, we've got an earthquake, we've got a face, we've got the Mercedes, we've got the crown, we've got the Imperator, have we? Yep. A GT20 and a GTR, yep. Bolt Hellcat, yep. A Rino Picciolo, a Mayan M6, a Spectre, an M6 and a Spectre, Urs and a Bianco. Urs, Bianco, alright, we've got all of them. And it's still worth finding, if it's a one, maybe a cheap two-star. I mean, it's interesting to do some of them up, but as there's nothing we actually want to get to, I think I'm just going to quit out and go to the next auction. Alright, and straight back to the auction. Okay, so fewer cars on the docket this time, so we've got a Castro Earthquake, a Delray Custom, Salem Flamum, Salem Flamey, yep, got one of them, Bianco, yeah, Hellcat, yeah, M6, and a Malloc, awesome, yep. I guess we could try looking at the next card to see if it's one star. It is a one star. I mean, the other reason I'm doing this is it takes a lot less time to load up the next card than it does to go back to the garage and back to here. Crikey, it was at the surface of the moon. Alright, let's buy this for... money purposes. We always need to keep our money going up as we had a problem quite a few episodes back now, about 10, 15 episodes back, we ran out of money and that was a bit tedious. Lots of little jobs and things for a while before I could buy another junker to do up. This is definitely the way to make money, just to buy up an old one star. Send it back to the garage. Right, okay, so now we might as well quit and go to a better auction. Right, so there's one shoddy piece of crap, and let's go and look for another car we don't already own. It's auction time, we're here again. It's the GT20 and that, yep, got. Bolthorn, Grand Mojave, yep, got. Reno, yep, Parity, yep, Earthquake, yep. So, you start wondering whether you've actually... Are there any cars that I don't have? I think there's another Mayan M. I've got the M6. Is there an M8? I think there might be. Alright, let's try one more auction. Oop, we're back. Alright, so I'm going to try one more trip to the auction, and then if that doesn't work, I'm going to have to do it off-cam, I think. This is just tedious for all concerned. Alright, so, Royal Crown got Tempest Magnum. Got GTR, yes, Delray Custom, yes, Kieran. Salem Kieran? Yeah. That's because I'm pretty sure I had one. Malloc, yeah, Mojave, yes, and Urs, yes. So yeah, I've got all these. Well, let's check the next car out, see if it's cheap, or one star. And I guess I'll have to have a look for a car that I already own off cam, because this is just a little bit tedious. Anyway, so this is 2-star. I could get this, I think, just for fun, and haven't worked on many of these Mercedes. Put an arbitrary amount that it'll definitely go for more than. I'll say I won't bid for more. Like, I won't bid more than 30 grand for this, and watch it inexorably go up to over 30 grand. Oh, pardon me, got all excited then. Oh no, it's getting there, it's almost getting all the way around. It's like it heard me. 30 grand you want to pay, it said. No, I don't want to pay any more than 30 grand. Right, that'll do. Right, let's go back and do up the car we did buy. Alright, so we ended up with a Delray custom. I've already got a custom in the garage, so this is just do up and sell. Presumably we can find a car in there somewhere. Alright. And I guess... Oh, there's a tail like that. That's dirt there. And I guess, like I say, I'll have to look for stuff I don't already own off camera. Just takes a goddamn long doing it on camera. Well, you know, just doing it. I mean, it doesn't make any longer because you're on camera. Right. So we are taking it all out. It being everything, and out being well, not in the car. Don't think I need to explain that really. Good. Right. So slightly old style engine. Carburetors and such. I should have taken a note of how much money I spent before I started work on this, but never mind. Never mind. It'll render us a profit. That's all we need to worry about. Now, there's two more parking slots to buy, each costing like 100 grand or something now. There were only 50 grand originally for all of them or something. And it does make one wonder. I mean, obviously people don't necessarily all want to just have unique cars. Maybe some people have got, like, different coloured versions of some cars, I don't know. But, I kind of assume there'd be enough space... Well, I swear there is enough space for everything, even if I've run out of unique vehicles. But, like I said, I'm fairly sure there's more vehicles. Maybe not enough for a unique one in every single slot, but, of all six parking structures as it is now. But, hey, I'll have a look at a list, because it might be that I'm searching for a specific vehicle, you know, rather than check my list of stuff that I've already got, it might be easier to have a list of things I don't have and just search for those. Anyway, I'll think of something and try and get some more vehicles, presuming there are some I don't already have, or maybe it's just that, you know, I've come to the end of my run of this game without anything more to do. Try the hard mode for shits and giggles and then maybe put it to bed. But I just keep, like, coming back to it. Something... I can easily chat and play the game, so it's quite good fun to make the videos. You know, they're not very interesting to watch, but, you know, whatever. Watching someone resemble a car whilst chatting inanely. You know, it's got to interest a few people, hasn't it? It has to. Whatever. Now the joy of the internet. Put your own nonsense up and people can... ignore it to their heart's content. Alright, the main problem with this engine is that it's got these fiddly old rocker arms. It's an old V8, so it's got these old rocker arm and things, whereas the modern ones are much more efficient in their use of parts, I guess. It helps if you've got fewer parts, less can go wrong, but... Or maybe it's just that they've miniaturised all these bits, I don't know, whatever. But anyway, it turns out this engine's a little bit fiddly to sort out. That's not a huge issue, it's just something to talk about. Oop, there we go. Oh, sparkles. There we go. Take off this bit. The heady part. The head. Has it not come out? Oh no, I've forgotten this obvious bolt here. Right. So, what else can we remove from here? Do we need to take off the starter? No, we can't. Right, might as well just lift it up then. Get on underneath. No, don't take the oil pan off yet. What am I doing? Who knows, I think, is the answer to that. Who indeed knows? Alright, take off the corners. Forget everything that I've remembered about this game. Forget everything I've remembered. It's a bit of an oxymoron, isn't it? Or a tautology, or whatever it is I mean. It's a bit like one of those things, isn't it? What things? You know, the things where people say a thing, it doesn't mean the thing they think they meant. Okay, yeah, that's pristinely clear. I think I've swallowed the wrong lexicography this morning. What the hell I'm saying. Some people say this morning. How is that different from any other day? Well, despite that being perfectly fair, grrr. Right, so take off all the suspension belonging, and I don't know what I meant then, and all this, and the outer tie rods, and the steering rack, don't forget your thingy, sway bar, yeah, I can name the parts I'm taking off, actually I can't, not that, there's a lower suspension arm, knuckles, I can tell you about the bush though, not much about it, yeah. It likes to be screwed in. Right. Can we get the drive shaft? Nope. Further down the car. Nope, too far away. There we go. Drive shaft. And ultra long adapter to reach all over there. Awesome. Okay. Now we can take off the gearbox. Ignore the strange black hole where the starter motor used to be. Use metaphysics in our cars. Right. Clutch. Flywheel. Okay, so we can get down the rear end now and strip out the all of it. There we go. Oh, drum brakes at the back. You can take off the axle without take off the drum bit, the brake bit. Who knew? Well, that's the curtain call of everyone but me. Alright, so get these leaf springs off. Take off the U-bolts, all covered in chocolate. Oh, got some bush to get out. Prise out the bush with your fingers. Zoomed in, haven't I? That's why I can't see what I'm doing half the time. See, you're either miles away or too close. That's the joy of Zoom. Zoom! Right. There we are. So, same again. Yeah, yeah. Come on. Just doing it too fast, that's all. Alright, so, U-bolt. U-bolt. Yeah, changing emphasis in sentences can be hilarious. Can be hilarious. Can be hilarious. Can be hilarious. Right. So, there we have the rear end off. Right, so now we need to yo-yo the engine. Oh no, first we need to clear out the oil, of course. Scrape out the goo. With the help of gravity and my oil buddy. For some reason I like to call it my oil buddy, because, you know, I'm lonely. No, I don't want to do that. I want to do that. Loop, 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 loop. Awesome, right. You notice how the oil body itself has some sort of self-cleaning mechanism? Because usually once you've used this, it'll be all caked in oil. But no, the oil's just vanished. Good. If only it could do that with those yellow and black textures. Reflection texture things. Well. So there's the rusty plastic bottom. And take off our bearing caps so that the crankshaft sags whilst we leave it in situ. And then we do my yo-yo thing. Patented yo-yo. Well, it's not patented, or even, anyway. It's not like everyone else has to do this to get their bits out of their engine. Just I chose to call it yo-yoing, which probably someone else has managed to think of. Anyway. Good. We're almost at the bit where I'm stop able. I was about to say, I've almost come to the part where I'm less able to think about what I'm saying. Irony all round. Oops. Oh, what have I left connected to this? Oh, excuse me. Right. What have I not taken off? Oh, look, the whole timing cover shenanigans. It just looks the same as the rest of it. I hadn't noticed. And the timing chain, of course, attached to the crankshaft. So now we can remove the crankshaft. Just trying to pull it off before it's connected to something. Alright, there we go. And then back down so we can lift out the engine block. And then that'll be that! In a record time of less than normal. Oh, forgot the camshaft, of course. That was connected to the timing chain via the cam gear. Okay, so that's all of that. Let's go and fix as much of it as we can. Oh, you can fix the distributor, can you? Seems a bit weird. Why is this not fixing? What's going on? Alright. Well, it's all got a bit weird. Seems to be working now, though. Not everything's broken, just a lot of it. So in fact, you have to fix each item several times as well, so each item has much more than 10% chance of being broken. Okay, that's that done, and then we basically stick it all back in the car. It's as simple as that. If you think that is simple, then that's awesome. If you think it's complicated, it's as complicated as that. Delete is applicable. Alright, so that's all the stuff I can put in from the top. Oh yeah, that reminds me that there's a phase that I forgot. So you sell all the junk, and then you sort by condition. Back in the car, so I'll sit there going, oh, do you want to put me back in the car? I don't know why we didn't sell all that stuff. Oops, and, you know, then you wouldn't absent-mindedly sell all the stuff that you've prepared. That was awesome. Right, okay, let's lift it up and do some suspension work. A lot of the parts of the engine need to be bought, because they're fixable. Right, front steering knuckle, front wheel hub. I've only got one of each of these, that's a shame. Having none means that you can buy them, but I don't know if that's any more efficient. But only having to buy one is a bit annoying, but if you have to buy two of everything, at least no. Front suspension crossmember short. I don't know what I'm saying. No, that's particularly news to anyone. Front suspension crossmember short. Nope, it's not in here. Not in running gear. Let's try putting it short in. There's not going to be many of them. Okay. Yeah. No. Bottom suspension arm, no. So we need two bottom suspension arms. So bottom. For some reason it feels better to go in and buy two of a thing rather than just having to buy one. I think that's what I was trying to express earlier, very poorly. So we need inner and outer tie rods and double wishbone doodads. I don't need those. Well, I might need those. I don't know what I'm doing anymore. What's going on? Tie rods. Heavens for Betsy. Alright, okay. Okay, I do need springs. What am I like? Front spring. A couple of caps. Certainly. That's almost certainly. Just certainly. Front sway bar. Front sway bar. And then we should have the end links. End link B. Sway bar, end link, B, multi-bolts, or nutty nuts in this case. Right, we've got this wheel hub cap things. We need rubber bushings times at least four. Need a couple, four for the back as well, I think, actually. I can't remember if there's small ones I need though, so we're going to wait for that. Do enough buying of stuff that I don't need, as it is. Alright, okay, so we need a front steering knuckle B. Front steering knuckle B. And then we need, what's it, front wheel hub to go in it. Front wheel hub. Should be right here. Oh, there it is. Front wheel hub. Lovely jubbly, and then upper. I've not got any of this stuff, have we? Upper suspension arm. Should be, yeah. Sam. I thought I knew my alphabet, just I don't know my words. I know where to look, just not how to see the thing I'm looking for. Bottom suspension arm. Good. What else? Oh yeah, we've got the wishbone doohickey, and it's spring and cap. End link, and the tie rods. Alright, oh yeah, we've got a little wheel hub dicky to put in there. Good, that's all of those chunks. Oh, we could do the clutch while we're here. Oh, do you not have a crankshaft? V8 OOV. Crankshaft V8 OOV. We'll need a battery. Crankshaft V8 OOV. Get one of them, pop that in, and then we can pop on our flywheel, etc. So, did I buy two? I think I bought two of those. Double click. Clutch plate. We might have the pressure plate. I think that's the bit that sometimes gets kept. Nope. Don't have a fresh bit of everything. Bolty bolts. Release bearing. And then do we have the big bit of metal? We do. Nice. Cleaned its black hole so we can put the starter motor back in place. Except we don't have one. Starter motor, oh no, it's not there. Starter motor V8. And whilst I see them on that page, I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of those. And those rocker arm doohickeys. What are they called? Rocker arms? You know those rocker arm things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. Alright, good, so there's some other bits that I need. Right, so what can we do now? We need the exhaust. Let's do that. So what's that? Front exhaust pipe, V8 OV. Two of those required. And then we've got two middle muffs and two rear muff out V8 OVs. Alright, so two middle muffs and two rear muffs V8 OVs. Alright, that's a fairly short exhaust section. We like. There we go. Click on find it. Right, leaf spring. No, don't have one of those. So was it a leaf spring rear drive? So leaf spring. Right. Cool. Does this zoom out a bit? No. That's just where we are. There we go. Rear ackle. Rear ackle. Knuckle has. Ackle. Ackle. Waka. 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 Right. That's the noises. Leaf spring. Leaf spring plate. It's only two U-bolts. Excuse me. Rear shock B. Rear shock B. Okay, so what else do we need here? Small rubber bushings. So there we are. I'm glad I didn't buy the big ones. Small rubber bushing. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm just going to have to screw these in. Oh, wait. Some of them you do. Alright, so, oh, fuel tank, no, I don't think you ever fixed them up with a hammer. Tank. Do we have the pump? No. Crikey, they're nearly always fixable. Pump. Fuel. Alright, let's do the side of the rear. So we need a rear axle knuckle housing B. Rear axle knuckle housing B. And then a solid rear drive axle. Solid rear drive axle. Screw that in. And then we need a leaf spring. Good, good. Leaf spring. Two of them as well. Leaf spring. Rubber bush. Leaf spring plate. New bolt. There we go. And then, and that's the suspension at the back done, I think. Drive shaft. Lovely. All nice and grey. It's like the beige of the now. Oh, it's like the 70s of the now, is what I meant. Words don't fail me now. Right, drum cylinders, that's all that. So, let's go back at the front and do engine-y things. This is where we are, at the front, so we need to drop it here at the top of the engine. That's a technical term. Do some peering. That's where you get the word term peerage from. People used to do this job. So we need 8 pistons with con rods. They're the rods that con you out of your work and pensions. Pistons, where are you? P for piston. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Those little puppets. There we go. 4 pistons. Where's my cursor? There we go. Piston. 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 Now we've got a head. And lots of different ways to get ahead. Yes, laughing more forcefully is probably one of them. Ha 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 ha. Yeah. Whoops, clicking in all the wrong places. Trying to do it too fast. Right, and then I'm going to screw these buggers in, which is annoying. So, screw, screw, screw. Screw, screw, screw. Oh yeah. Alright. So, we did have roughly 180, I think, before we went to the auction. And now we're down to 150. I guess this car could be worth a decent amount. I just... doesn't feel like it would be. It's old, but I don't know. Doesn't necessarily mean it's not worth much. Ah, yeah, sparkles. No, I bought sparkles, didn't I? Already. Like I knew what I was doing. Or some shit. There we go. Distributor? No. Okay. Let's do the other engine head side thingy majiggles. So, oh. So we need an engine head for V8. Oh. Engine head, V8. Right, there we go. Just a couple of bolts. Just the 7 bolts. Or is it 8? It's 8 bolts. And push in your rods. There we go. That's as exciting as you can imagine. Well, it's only marginally less exciting for you watching this, because I get to press the right click and then the left click. It's palpably exciting, obviously. There we go. And I've got the head cover on. And we've got one of them. Engine head cover A. V8 OOV. Just even more bolts for that. Don't want that to come off. Right, so engine and exhaust manifold via exhaust manifold. Overhead valves, is that what we decided that might be for? I don't know. That's all I ever say. Anyway, good, so that's all that done. Oh, and it's the top isn't quite finished yet. We've got the intake manifold for 1 carb. Intake manifold. 1 carb. And then the carb itself. No, so we need a 4 barrel carb at Moretta. 4 barrel. we've got the air filter, is it on top of that? Right, and air filter base. And the air filter were previously purchased, and then the lid, which I don't have either. Round air filter base, round air filter cover. Alright, that's the top of the engine done. So we've got the ignition distributor. I guess you could class this as part of the top of the engine as well. Ignition distributor. This thing, and then it's the rotor arm, and then the cap. And a couple of little clips that you can't see because the ignition wires want to go on instead. Don't have to get your clips, otherwise it'll be moaning at you later. Clip B. That's an annoying reflection on it. Get an angle. And there we go. Right, and then the distribution wires, they'll be needed. Ignition wires V8. Ignition wires V8. So that's the top of the engine done. Alright, get in there. Get in there. No radiator. Good. Radiator. Yeah, and the fan. Do we need to find out? The fan goes on the front of the engine, doesn't it? So we need a fuel filter. Cam gear V8. Over. Oops, something in the eye. Ow. Oh. Cam gear V8 over. Silver one. Yeah. And timing belt V8 over. So, timing belt V8 over. And then what was the other thing? I wanted a fuel filter. There we go. Pop that on. Timing cover. Yep. Good. I'm going to put the radiator cover on in front of that. That makes it all much easier. Right, water pump, no. Crankshaft pulley, no. So we need a water pump and crankshaft pulley V8. Earth. Water pump V8. Do we need a water pulley thing as well? I don't really know. Water pump pulley, yes. But it's just a normal one. Oh yeah, they have special versions of those, don't they? Oh, I thought we were going to put a fan on the front of this. Oh, we've got the belts to put on first. Excuse me, so belts V8 OOV. V8 OOV. And then we can put the radiator fan on the front. Okay, radiator fan. V8 OOV. Few bolts on the front of that, and that I believe is the engine almost finished. So battery, yeah, we bought one of them. What about the brake servo? No, need one of those. Brake servo. All right, so get in there, son. Get in there. No, we don't need that. What am I doing? We've done that. It's the reverse of that, in fact. Putting it back on, or we need the crankshaft bearing cap. Crankshaft bearing cap. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba. Crankshaft bearing cap. Nope. Nearly. Very similar. There we go. And then the oil pan. Nope, don't have that. And the oil filter. So, oil filter, oil pan. There we go, it was rusty plastic, now it's reflective plastic. Or maybe it's metal, who knows. Who knows? It's like, who could fathom such a thing? Right, I think that's the engine done. So now we need to do the brakes. So we need two ventilators, two pads. That's all we know we need at the moment. So, do we have any calipers? No, so we need two calipers as well. And then do we have a wheel? We have a couple of wheels, so we need a couple of them as well. Break desk, break pad, Cali pa 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 pa. Doom Retro 12s. Alright, and then the rear end is slightly different. It's got drum brakes, so we need drum wheel cylinders times 2. And then these shoes might have been fixed. No, nope, so we need 2 shoes. And then the drum. Alright. There's usually more of this that gets fixed, but none of it got fixed this time. And the tyres, of course. Wheel shop, rim retro 12. Rim retro 12, right down the bottom. There we go. With its yellow and black reflections. Awesome. Shoe, drum. There we go. Nice and simple. Oh, so there we are. I think that's all the body parts done. Let's just have a look. No parts missing. Body condition 2%. That's awesome. Oh, did I not put all the bodywork back on? Yeah. There wasn't much of it, to be fair. Okay. Found a bit. Woo. Hell yeah. Alright, that's some of it anyway. So we need doors. So this is what a Delray Custom, isn't it? So off to the bodywork shop for the custom. Doors, headlight, I can't remember. Headlight, I don't need a right headlight as well, just whatever it was I bought. So front bumper and front hood thing. Hood thing, yeah, hood. Alright, oh, front right fender. So, oh yeah, door. Right, and then we can fix up the remainder. So hang on, let's just do a poll. So that's 88%. It's worth 52 grand. Now it's worth 72 grand. I'd say that was definitely worth doing for £2,000, an extra 20 out of it. Awesome, so that's it. Took quite a long time, so apologise, and that's mainly because of the auction nonsense at the start, but I'll have to go and do some off-cam, because it's not much fun to watch. Good, so here we are, let's sell it, get our monies. Who was waiting for me to try and do that going, you can't sell it yet, you can't. It's one of my old favourites. It's like not putting the engine cover on the engine in the previous game. Ugh. Right, there's the oil. I don't even need to look at how much oil's in the stick because I know my stuff, but in case those of you don't, right, the centre lot. Right, now we can sell it. Take it away. Yes. Shouldn't it be worth ever so slightly more now it's got oil in it? No, that's right, it shouldn't. Alright, thanks for watching. Come back soon for more of the same or slightly similar or slightly similar but different. You know the score.